Welcome back to my channel. Today, I want to talk about branding. What is branding for an artist and why it is important? In the past, I have done 3 other videos. If you want to check it out, I'll drop a playlist in the description below. And I thought those videos on branding would be a great success. But to my surprise, almost nobody watched them. And I was like, that was unexpected. And I found out that a lot of artists think branding is bad for an artist. And this is a cliche. It is, a traditional point of view on business as an artist. And I think it has a good reason, because when we think about famous brands, we think about Coca-Cola, maybe McDonald's, Google, eBay, or Walmart, and we don't think about Picasso or Van Gogh, because although they are famous artists, we don't consider them as strong brands. And I think it's a cliche that I want to change. I want to talk about what is branding as an artist and how you can use branding to achieve whatever you wish to achieve. If you want to be the next Kaos, you can through branding. You don't have to spend thousands of dollars or hundreds of thousands on branding and to become a large company, to have a big team. You can use branding for any other purposes, even for not-for-profit projects. And you can make a name for yourself as an artist, and there's nothing to feel ashamed about. And that's really the essence I want to transmit in this video. And now let's go back to the fundamentals. According to, let's say, the marketing book, a brand is a name, term, design, symbol, or other feature that identifies one seller's goods or service as a distinct from those of other sellers. I think the keyword distinct is very important. You want to be distinctive. But this definition is a bit textbookish. It doesn't really tell much about how you should achieve this. And I looked around and I found another definition, more contemporary definition, by a Silicon Valley marketeer, Marty Neumeier. He said in a recent interview from the Future, a brand is a result. It's a customer's gut feeling about a product, service, or a company. It ends up in their heads, in their hearts. He gave us a lot more emotional interpretation of what a brand should achieve, and I think it's especially suitable for creative entrepreneurs, because a branding is a result. It's not about what you want to say, like, I'm a good artist, I make different art, buy my art, but how other people would understand and perceive your art. And that is really important, because you don't say it in a smart way, it will never reach the minds, the heads, and the hearts of other people. And again, it's very important to make that emotional connection, like steal their hearts. You need to make them fall in love with your art in order to establish a strong brand as an artist, because you cannot convince them, like, my art is good value, like, logically, reasonably. What really will make the sales is the fact that you make them fall in love and they make a very emotional, impulsive purchase. And they say, you know, I have to buy this art now because it's unique, and if I don't buy it, someone else will buy it, and I will lose this once in a lifetime opportunity to have a piece of art from this special artist. That is the result you wish to achieve. And most of artists would use a personal brand to achieve this branding, and that is to say, you use your own name, artist name, you use your own history, and maybe you have been painting for the past 10 years, maybe you're from a special art school, maybe you have traveled the world and come back to your country and started painting about all the journeys, right, the journey to the West, and all of that can be transported to the new brand image of your art. And it's a double-bladed sword, because guess what? The good side is you can use all of that personal history and strength and personality and personal charm, especially if you're charming, like you are a physically attractive young man or a young woman, whatever characteristic that you think that could appeal to some people, then yeah, you can use your personality and who you are. But the downside is that there are going to be some people who would not like you, right? It's not about who you are or who they are, it's a combination of everything. And no matter what qualities you show, what personalities that you show, there are going to be people who just don't like it, just not into it, just dislike it to the core, and there's nothing you can do about it. And my personal advice is, let the haters hate, and you just have to shake it off. No matter what, there are people going to be like that, and this can be compensated by the extreme diehard fans. You show that, for example, you show a vulnerability, you show that you suffer from a mental illness and you're painting the, let's say, your imaginative world. And some people will be scared and think it's too dark and think it's a taboo. But some people will say, you know what, I totally feel it because I have been through the same and I want to collect every piece of art from this artist because I emotionally, you know, feel it. So I think no matter what, you're gonna find your fans, you're gonna find your haters, and forget about the haters, it's very important to make a strong circle of diehard fans. And now let's talk about ROI, return on investment, because again, a lot of artists ask me, hey, you know, I want to build a strong brand, so tell me how much money I spend and how much money I will get back. This is not a Facebook advertisement campaign. You don't get back the money 1 week after, you know, you don't spend $50 and have 100 back as sales. It doesn't work like that. Branding is a long-term strategy, is a long time of work without a certainty. I would say this is like investing in a startup company, and maybe the company will go boom and become a unicorn and you earn a lot, and maybe it's never gonna be a success. And also it's like going to art school and you tell your parents, I want to go to art school, I need $60,000, please help me. And your parents say, okay, so how long are you going to make back the $60,000 and how much interest rate are you going to give me? You will not be able to answer this question, just like the unicorn company startup entrepreneurs were not able to answer those questions. When it comes to branding as an emerging artist, you really shouldn't think about return on investment as, let's say, as a sure, certain plan. And if you don't get it, you feel frustrated and you see other artists get it and you want the same timeline, it doesn't happen. There isn't a magic formula and there are a lot of uncertainty. You just have to believe in your plan and go for it. And it might take you a year, 2 years, 5 years, 10 years, even 30 years. But when you can cash out on your branding, on your success, you can cash out for the rest of your life. Like Picasso, of course, he started very early and he was very talented and he, of course, died later and his families are still benefiting from the brand he built. But guess what? It's just like Picasso. The sooner you start, the sooner you can enjoy from the branding success, and the longer you live, the more you can cash out from it. Go for it without thinking too much about the return on investment, because branding is not marketing. If you wonder what's the difference, you can check out this video also from the Futur. I find it very interesting. It's a debate among three people, two guest speakers and the host of the Futur, and they talk a lot about the difference between branding and marketing. Of course, there isn't a really clear line and it's overlapping a lot. And while I was watching this video, I found a very, very good comment in the comment box. And the comments are the best parts, right? It's saying, marketing is asking someone out on a date. Branding is the reason they say yes. And it really made me laugh, and I think it's really, really to the essence of what is branding and what is marketing. Marketing is when other people look at your art, and branding is the reason that they want to buy your art. And if you want a lot of people to look at your art, then go for marketing. If you want the people who look at your art would buy your art, you have to build a core brand value and really answer those key questions. Why are you doing what you're doing? Why you exist as an artist? Why you choose this career path instead of doing any other things? Why your art is different from the art of many other artists? Even the visual style can be very, very similar. And why you make and sell art at this price? Because after all, you are turning a $15 stretched canvas into a $15,000 piece of art. You have to give a lot of valid reasons. And the reason is your branding, is your branding story, is the values that you bring, and again, is the results. You have to transmit all of that story and project it successfully into the minds, the heads, and the hearts of your potential collectors, and build a strong fan base, and then interact with them, cultivate your fans. Even if you are doing a not-for-profit, project, like an art project, or if you want to donate all of your earnings to a not-for-profit, you can build a brand based on your cause. And you can even build a stronger brand because you're not trying to sell anything. And this can be a branding strategy, not necessarily a marketing strategy. You see, there is a difference. And that's why even if you're an artist who rejects commercialization of your art, you don't necessarily must reject branding. When you separate branding from marketing, you can focus on the reason why you make art, the reason why they should buy your art, and the whole, let's say, life story as an artist that are not necessarily always commercial, of course. If you want to have a commercial success like Run English, you can very well build a brand, web store, marketing, branding all in one, right? So it's not mutually exclusive, although it's overlapping. And that's the branding I want to show you, I want to tell you and explain to you as an artist, as a creative professional entrepreneur. And don't reject this idea too quickly. Keep an open mind, an open heart. Just embrace everything and just give a go, make a name for yourself. Maybe you will like it, you'll see a lot of positive results. That's all for today. If you would like to know more about branding and marketing as an artist, leave me a comment in the comment box below. Thank you very much for watching. See you in the next video.